Just another taste. Skål, guys. Really powerful, really heavy in the palate, very sweet the second time around, and then comes that long, long, powerful, aromatic and complex finish. Hello everyone. So today the second Willemoes beer in this series, and today we have the stout. This stout is it's the porter, of course. And the porter usually is my favorite kind of beer. Just behind that comes stout and Belgian ale. So this one I'm really looking forward to. It's the same price as the others, 11 crowns. Well, that's the cheapest I've found it for half a liter. 11 crowns is only about $2 American or pounds or euros, so really cheap. It's 8.5% alcohol, so that's pretty heavy on the ABV, and I'm really looking forward to tasting this. So let's just jump into it. It's best served at 10 to 11 degrees Celsius. I've had this out of the refrigerator for almost an hour, so this is probably around 8 or 9 degrees. So, but I guess it will work anyway. There's no sponsored content in this video, and as always, everything on this channel is just my opinion. So, but let's get into the most important thing, which is, of course, the nosing and tasting. If I remember correctly, it's just as dark as the stout, but the foam is a little bit more heavy and a little bit more also browner than the stout was. Immediately, there's coffee and chocolate. Bitterness, but a lot of malty sweetness. So that's the nose. Cheers. The palate is very similar to the stout. There's malty sweetness. There's a little bit of coffee and a little bit of chocolate, and then over to the finish, which is, or the palate, the only thing that's different is the ABV is higher, so there's more power there. Then over to the finish, which is a lot more powerful than the stout. There's a lot more bitterness, there's a lot more, it's just a lot heavier, and there's a lot more flavor going on. So it's really good. It's very, very good. Let's just see. Yeah. So there's actually licorice in this. So barley malt and hops is made from them. And then there's actually licorice in this, which is why the heavy licorice bitterness in the aftertaste or in the finish is there. But it's really good. Really, really good. Just another taste. Skål, guys. Really powerful, really heavy in the palate, very sweet the second time around, and then comes that long, long, powerful, aromatic and complex finish. This is really, really good. Really, very, very good. Where should I put this? Because this is very up there. If I would take the price into consideration, this would be a 10, but it doesn't taste as good as the Rochefort 10, which I gave a 10. So it's a 9 or a 9.5. Think about it, $2, 2 euros for half a liter for something that tastes this good. I'm gonna put it at 9.5. It is very, very good. But yeah, it's very, very good. Very powerful, very good. 9.5 for the Willemoes Porter for me. Something I say sometimes is, for me, when a beer is really good, it has to feel like, almost feel like a meal. That's how heavy and powerful and satisfying it must be, in my opinion. And this does just that. So 9.5 for the Willemoes Porter, in my opinion. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And feel free to share it with friends and family. If you don't like it, thumbs down, that's fine too. Whatever you do, please do leave a comment. I will respond to all the comments. I especially do like serious questions about what I do and ideas to new video. I really like them, but as I said, I will respond to all comments. Subscribe if you want to see more videos like this, and maybe hit that bell button so you don't miss out. Oh yeah, if please go check out my Instagram, it's dunkeren_. There's a lot of pictures of what I do on an everyday basis, also some video clips, and I try to always have my something in my story just to keep everybody posted. So thank you for watching, and next up we will have the Belgium ale, and after that we will have a normal ale. So have a good day. Goodbye.